little Jimmy Lee Dean story. Jimmy wrote that song Criminals. He was staying in my house, and on the CD cover, the picture on the CD cover was taken in my backyard, but that's not what I'm going to tell you about. There used to be this bar up on the north side. What was it called?
Starlight.
Pressure cooker.
And we both.
Now I'm embarrassed. No, it was on airline. I now I'm embarrassed as both. The pressure cooker. Cedar Lounge. And Jimmy played back there in the 70s, because back in the 70s on Wednesday afternoon, all the ladies would put the food in the crock pot, and then they would go there, and it was banned on Wednesday afternoons, and the guys that were off on Wednesday would go there and try to get lucky with the married ladies and stuff. Jimmy was in a band that played there, but just a few years ago he was playing there, and I happened to be there that night, and there was a girl working behind the bar that Jimmy had gone to high school with, and she was dating this great big tall mean looking cowboy hat, badass looking guy, you know. And Jimmy was telling this story up on stage about how when he was in high school, the girls in the school, they if they thought the dresses were too short, they had to get on their knees, and if the dress didn't touch the floor, then they had to go home and change and put on a longer dress. And he said something to this girl. He said something about, your dress never touched the floor, did you? Well, this cowboy she was dating was real jealous anyhow. And he was really jealous of Jimmy because for some reason he thought something was going on between her and Jimmy. Not that Jimmy would ever, you know. Anyway, here he comes back to the stage. And I'm sitting about where this guy over here is sitting. And back then, Charlie Mullins was playing steel with Jimmy. And Charlie always had at least two guns on him. He was a engineer at Baker Hughes, and they had him on a whole suitcase full of experimental medication and stuff like that. He was always really wound up, he made guns on the side, and he always had at least two on him. And this big cowboy comes up, and he stands right in front of the stage, and I'm thinking, I reached around and grabbed my chair, and I'm thinking, if this son of a bitch hits Jimmy, I'm gonna bust him with this chair. And then I looked up and I realized, oh shit, if Charlie pulls a gun, I'm right in the line of fire. So I just kind of back off. Well, nothing happened, and Jimmy took a break. And when Jimmy took a break, this guy come over to where Jimmy was standing at the table, and he gets up like he's gonna get in Jimmy's face. Well, Jimmy, he was standing there, had a lot of blood wads in his hand. He's gonna fix this guy, so he reaches out like they do in the movies, you know, like they're gonna break that bottle and cut that guy up. Hit that bottle on the table, it bounced right back up and right between the eyes. That big old cowboy was standing there, and you could see the sweat breaking out on his forehead. All of a sudden, his mouth started quivering and he started giggling and just turned around.
True story, ladies. That was when I first found out they started putting plastic in beer bottles so they wouldn't break when you ran over them with your car and stuff, or threw them out the highway and stuff. They would bounce. They'll bounce off the barroom table too.